Hi, I'm Eric. This is a demo of my PhD project, SIEUFERD, a visual query system. So, since the late 70s, we've had these really useful things called relational databases. Companies use them to store all kinds of data. Problem is, they are primarily a tool for programmers. Here's an example of the code you'd have to write to pull some data out of a database and do some calculations on it. This is the computer language we call SQL or SQL. I'm going to show you a much easier way to do database queries. This is a tool that feels a lot like Microsoft Excel, except it's actually a full-blown query system, which means you can use it to formulate any query you could write in standard SQL, SQL 92. And yet it's completely graphical. There is no coding involved at all. The user does not have to know SQL to use the tool. The user interface looks like this. At all times, the user is going to be looking directly at some data in the database. Now, there's a bit of a trick to the way we visualize that data. We're using something called a nested table layout. This is going to allow us to visualize not only the data that's coming out of the database, but also the database query that was used to retrieve it. We'll get back to that. Starting from any column in the table on the screen, the user can open up a context menu. It looks like this. Here you can do all the usual spreadsheet operations, like filter, sort, etc., but also a few more things. If you hide a column, you can get it back using this box, and there's another box for setting filters. Now the neat thing is, using only the operations that you'll find in this menu, you can formulate all the same queries that you could write in SQL 92. I'll take you through the operations one by one. There's a few of them, but these are all you need. A typical relational database consists of several tables of data, so we usually start by opening up one of them. Here we are doing a simple database query that just selects a few columns from a table called Courses. The next thing we can do is to include data from another table in the database. I'm bringing in data from a table called Readings. This way we can see a list of university courses, and for each course, see the reading list of that course. This is what we call a join in the database world. Specifically, we are doing equi-joins over foreign key relationships. That's the terminology. You can do other kinds of joins as well, but these are the most common ones. Let's do a few more joins. We'll just need to select which tables and columns we want to show. We're now seeing the nested table layout that we talked about earlier. Each bold heading corresponds to a table in the database, so we are doing four joins between five tables and visualizing the whole query at the same time. You'll see a little crow's foot icon some places in the header. That means there's a one-to-many relationship, so each course can have multiple readings in the reading list, and independently of that, it can have multiple sections and so on. You can also do sorting at multiple levels. Here we are sorting each reading list by author name and then by title, and then we're sorting the overall course list by the maximum enrollment limit. The next thing we can do is filter. Here we're showing only courses with a Wednesday meeting. There's also an option that relates to which level at which a filter should apply. Here we're tweaking the query to show all courses, but for each course, only show sections for which there are Wednesday meetings. Let's just clean up this query a bit for the next example. Now we're going to do some calculations. We can do a formula, like in Excel, to find the duration of each meeting. In this system, formulas are set for an entire column at a time. Then we can do another formula to find the total duration of all meetings. Now this formula we've inserted at the course level, so we're going to get totals per course rather than, say, per section. If we set a filter on the input to an aggregate function, like a sum, then the total will change. Okay, let's adjust the query a bit again for the next example. Sometimes you need to collapse duplicate values into a single row. There's a separate option for that. This corresponds to a select distinct query in SQL. And there's also a way to do more traditional joins like those you see in SQL instead of the nested joins that we've seen here. Here's an example of what we call a left join. So to summarize, we have a completely graphical user interface for doing arbitrary SQL queries, and we've managed to keep the user always looking at the exact data that's going through the query at every point. This is actually the first system to do this. We did a couple of user studies on this system. In a controlled study, we found Microsoft Access 2016 comparing rather abysmally in terms of usability. You're welcome to check out our SIGMOD paper for more details. Here are a couple of quotes from our users. To conclude, we've shown you SIEUFERD, which is the first visual query system to let users create and modify arbitrary database queries by directly manipulating data on the screen.